Welcome back, children. Let's see the points we have discussed in the previous video. We have discussed algebraic expressions, polynomials, types of polynomials based on the number of terms, isn't it? Now, let's move on to next topic. Next, consider the polynomial Px equal to x raised to 4 minus 2x raised to 6 minus 3x square plus 1. This is a polynomial in x. And check the powers of the variable. Here 4, here 6, here 2, and here it is a constant term. Okay, which is the highest power? 6, isn't it? So this highest power we are calling as degree of this polynomial. So for this polynomial, what is its degree? Degree is 6. Okay, children. Now come to the second polynomial. This is also a polynomial in one variable. We are discussing only polynomial in one variable. Which is the highest power? Here 2, here 32, here 5. 32 is the highest one. So what is the degree of this polynomial? 32. Okay, here what is the degree of the polynomial? 3 is the highest one. So degree is 3. And here what is the degree? Here y power is 1, isn't it? So that is the highest one. So its degree is 1. Okay, children. So what is the degree of a polynomial in one variable? The highest power of the variable is called degree of the polynomial. It is only for polynomial in one variable. The highest power of the variable is called degree of the polynomial. Okay, now consider one constant polynomial. Constant polynomial. See, 6 is a constant polynomial, isn't it? So, how can you say the degree of this constant polynomial? Can you say? And we have already discussed, 6 can be written as 6x raised to 0, isn't it? So, what is the degree? 0. So, for a constant polynomial, the degree is 0. Okay. Minus 4, it is also a constant polynomial. So what is the degree? Degree is 0. So here also degree 0. Okay, children. But what about the degree of 0 polynomial? 0 polynomial degree. 0 is called 0 polynomial, isn't it? How will you say the degree? Can you say? It is not defined. Degree of a zero polynomial is not defined. Why? Because zero can be written with a variable with any power, isn't it? Zero can be written as 0x raised to 20. Or same, it can be written as 0x raised to 4. So, can you say one specific value for as the power of the variable? No. So, that's why the power of the degree of a zero polynomial we are saying as not defined. Okay, children. So, zero polynomial degree not defined. Not defined. Okay. So, degree of constant polynomial, 0. Degree of 0 polynomial, not defined. Okay, children? Is it clear? Now, come to this question. Come to this polynomial. Px is equal to x minus 5. What is the degree of this polynomial? Power is 1. So, degree is 1. Okay. So, if the degree of a polynomial is 1, that polynomial is called linear polynomial. Linear polynomial. So what is a linear polynomial? If the degree of a polynomial is 1, it is called linear polynomial. And here what is the degree? 2. So if degree is 2, here degree is 2 and it is called quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. And here what is the degree? Here what is the degree? So here it is 2x raised to 2 minus x raised x cube plus x minus 5. What is the degree? Degree is 3. Okay, it is called cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. So these are the types of polynomials you should know according to the degree of the polynomial. First degree polynomial is called linear polynomial. Second degree polynomial is called quadratic polynomial. And third degree polynomial is called cubic polynomial. Okay, children? Children, consider these polynomials. Okay, consider the first group 2x plus 5, then another one 6y, then third one 7 minus 4x. What type of polynomials are these? Here power higher degree is 1, here 1, here also 1. So these are linear polynomials. Okay, linear polynomials in one variable. Okay, now here how many terms? 2 terms. Here 1 term, here 2 terms. Can you try to write a linear polynomial in one variable with more terms, more than 2 terms? Let's try. We are considering only polynomial in one variable. Okay, so here I wrote 2x plus 5. Okay, can you write the polynomial? Can you write a linear polynomial with more than these 2 terms? So linear means power should be 1. So if we can add the term with more power, higher power, we can do that. But here it should be linear. So we can add the term with only degree power 1. So if I am adding this, see, one more term, we can write only like this. Power should be always 1 because we are considering linear. Or if we are adding one constant, it will come as 1. But actually look at this, 2x plus 5 plus 4x plus 1. These two are like terms. So we can simplify. So 2x plus 4x we can simplify. What is it? 6x. And this constant term also we can add. Plus 6. So again how many terms are there? Finally we got only 2 terms. So it means we can't write a linear polynomial in one variable with more than 2 terms. So we can have at most 2 terms for a linear polynomial in one variable. We can have 1 term. Okay, so 6y, it is a linear polynomial. We can have 1 term and maximum we can have 2 terms only. So we can't write a linear polynomial in one variable with more than 2 terms. Okay, children? And the general form of a linear polynomial will be, see, we should have one variable term with the power of the variable as 1. So a variable term, and it will have a coefficient. Coefficient, normally we are using the alphabet like A. Then in some polynomials we will have constant term also. In some linear polynomial only this much, and in some polynomials we will have constant terms also like this. So for constant term we are writing plus b. B is a constant. So this is the general form of a linear polynomial in one variable. Ax plus b is the general form of linear polynomial in one variable. And one more thing you have to keep in memory. This a should not be equal to 0. When you write the general form of a linear polynomial, you have to write this also. A should not be equal to 0. Why? If a is 0, this coefficient is 0, it will become 0x plus b. What is 0x plus b? 0x is 0. Then we will have only this constant term. Isn't it? So, it won't be linear polynomial. So, general form of linear polynomial is ax plus b, where a not equal to 0. Now consider another set of polynomials. What type of polynomial? Everywhere highest power is 2. So degree 2. So it is quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. So same way, in quadratic polynomial, how many maximum term? How many terms we can have? How many terms we can have? Maximum 3 terms only we can write, isn't it? So these are the examples. X minus 2x square plus 5. Now if we are having more terms, it should be either with power 1 or power 2 only. Then suppose another, consider one example, y square minus 2y plus 5. Can you write more terms in this quadratic polynomial? If we are adding more terms, it will be with the power 2 or with the power 1. Okay, so if we are adding this 2y square minus y plus 6. But again, we can have like terms, we can simplify. So, finally, again, it will become a quadratic polynomial with 3 terms. Y square plus 2y square, 3y square, then 2y minus y minus 3y plus 11. Again, it became 3 term, isn't it? And here, y square plus 9. It is also a quadratic polynomial with 2 terms. And y square minus 3y plus 1, 3 term. Here 2 term. And we can have 5x square. This is also a quadratic polynomial, one term polynomial. Isn't it? So a quadratic polynomial can have at most 3 terms. At most 3 terms. Okay. Linear polynomial can have at most 2 terms. Now consider next set of all polynomials. So here all the polynomials are having degree 3. So they are called cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. Okay. So here maximum how many terms we can have? Like this only we can have. Isn't it? How many? Here 4 terms. Maximum 4 terms we can have. So in cubic polynomial we can have at most 4 terms. We can have single term cubic polynomial or here binomial. Isn't it? 2 term cubic polynomial, here 3 term cubic polynomial, and we can have maximum 4 terms cubic polynomial. Okay. And what is the general form? Here also we didn't discuss the general form of quadratic polynomial. What will be the general form? The highest power should be 3. So, x raised to 3. 2, quadratic polynomial, highest power should be 2. Okay, so highest power 2. So here we can give coefficient A. Then we can have x term. So bx plus c. So this is the general term, general form of quadratic polynomial. Ax square plus bx plus c. And what condition we have to say? This x square term coefficient should not be equal to 0. So A should not be equal to 0. Okay, if A is 0, it will become 0 x square and then it will be linear polynomial. Okay, now what is the general form of cubic polynomial? Highest power should be 3. So x cube. So ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Then a should not be equal to 0. A should not be equal to 0. So if a is a becomes 0, this term will cancel. Okay, so A should not be equal to 0. But B and C, B, C and D we can have 0 as 0. If B 0, the x square term will vanish. So it will become like this. Isn't it? This polynomial. No x square term. But it is also a cubic polynomial. Because highest power is 3. And x term also can be, coefficient can be 0. So again it will be here, x term, no x term here. So but it is a cubic polynomial. Okay, now the b, c, d, if b, c, d, 0, it will be of this form. Okay, again cubic polynomial. So these are the general forms of linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial and cubic polynomial. Ax plus b, ax square plus bx plus 2, c and ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Here is a question for you. Classify the following polynomials as linear, quadratic and cubic. Okay children, consider the first one. X minus x square minus 3. So linear, quadratic and cubic we are classifying by checking the degree. What is the degree of this polynomial? Highest power is 2. So degree 2. So what is the polynomial of degree 2? Quadratic. Isn't it? So it is a quadratic polynomial. Then second one, what is the degree of this polynomial? 9 by variable power is 1. So what is it? Linear. Polynomial of degree 1 is called linear polynomial. And here what is the degree? 3. So it is cubic polynomial. Okay. And here what is the degree of this polynomial? Power is 2. So it is also quadratic. And what is the last one? What is the degree of this polynomial? X is also a polynomial, isn't it? So what is the degree? So it is also, x means x raised to 1. So its degree is 1. So it is linear polynomial. Okay children, did you understand all these concepts? Okay, now let us revise all the important definitions. You have to write all these important definitions and points in your note. Here is the homework for you. Okay, children, thank you.